Today we're going to talk a little bit about abrasives. Now the abrasives are going to be really important when it comes to grinding and polishing your glass in a cold working scenario. There are a lot of different abrasives out there on the market, and they do a lot of different things to the glass. Now understanding how these abrasives work with the glass is going to go a long way towards helping you figure out which products and tools are going to work the best for the process and solution that you need for your particular glass work. Before me on the table, I have four of our main abrasives. I have diamond, silicon carbide, aluminum oxide, and pumice. Now, when we talk about abrasives, it's going to be really important to discuss what's called a Mohs scale. It's M-O-H-S. It's basically a scale of how hard a material is. Obviously, if you try and use a softer material on a harder material, it's not going to actually do anything to that harder material. So it's really important to understand with your abrasives where they fall in terms of hardness. Now, most glass that you're going to come across is going to have a Mohs scale of around 5 to 5.5. It's right in the middle of the Mohs scale, you'd say. So anything that's a little bit higher is going to scratch or abrade your glass surface. Anything that's lower, the glass is going to be harder than, so it's not really going to damage the surface of your glass if you're using it. So going from left to right here, our diamond is going to be one of the hardest substances out there. It is a number 10 on the Mohs scale, so it's going to be very aggressive on your glass. Next we have our silicon carbide. Silicon carbide and aluminum oxide both are going to be a 9 on the Mohs scale, so they're only slightly less hard than the diamond is. That may surprise a few people, but they're very close to one another. Next is our pumice. Pumice is going to be a 6 on the Mohs scale. Now remember, our glass is only 5 or 5.5, so a 6 is very close to the glass, so it's going to very, very minorly abrade your glass. It's going to be a very soft touch on the glass. Now the Mohs scale is not the only thing we need to think about when we talk about abrasives though. I'm going to go a little bit more in depth with each of these abrasives to talk about how they differ from one another when you're using them on your glass. We've talked about Mohs scale and how hard each of these abrasives are. Now, the other thing to consider is what's called friability. Now, friability is how fragile or how easily an abrasive is to break. Diamonds are not friable at all. It takes a lot of pressure and a lot of strength to break a diamond, so they have very low friability. Silicon carbide, aluminum oxide, and pumice all have a very high friability. It means they break down relatively easily. By now you're probably asking yourself, well, what's the difference between the silicon carbide and the aluminum oxide? They're both 9 on the Mohs scale, they're both friable. Why choose one over the other? There are some differences between these two materials, though, that are very, very important. Along with the Mohs scale of how hard an abrasive is, and the friability, or how easily it breaks down, the third thing you want to think about when you think of abrasives is how sharp they are. The sharper an abrasive is, the more likely it's going to break down faster. While both of these abrasives are friable, which means they do break very easily, the silicon carbide is a sharper abrasive. So when you use silicon carbide, it's going to give you a rougher surface on your glass more readily. That also means that it's going to break down faster. So your silicon carbide is typically going to be a shorter lived abrasive than your aluminum oxide. The aluminum oxide, on the other hand, is not a very sharp abrasive. It's going to give you a much finer surface on your glass when you're using it for various things. That also means that the aluminum oxide is going to last longer, typically, than your silicon carbide. Because it is not as sharp as a silicon carbide, it will take longer for those grains to break down. The same can be true of diamond. Now, there are multiple styles of diamond out there in various grades of sharpness that are going to determine how long that diamond lasts or how quickly it will break. The sharper the diamond, the faster it will wear down. The duller the diamond, the longer it will last. A lot of diamond tools are a mixture of both of these styles of diamond. We are going to do a separate video on our diamond abrasives to show you the different ways diamond can be used in tools for your glass. But I did want to show you real quick one of the more common ways the diamond is used. This is one of our electroplated diamond discs. So you can see on the surface here, we have diamond that has been applied to the surface. and then it is stuck in place with nickel on the disc. So it is electroplated, bonded to the substrate, so that's held in place. This is pretty typical for a use for diamond in a lot of different formats, be it a flat lap diamond disc or diamond wheels or belts. We will cover this again in a separate video that is strictly on diamonds and the various types of diamond tools out there and how they work compared to one another. But I did want to show you real quick just a tool that is commonly used with diamonds for grinding your glass. Knowing how rough a cut these two abrasives will give you on your glass will be a good way to know which route you need to go for your finished product. A lot of times, loose grit silicon carbide and loose grit aluminum oxide are used in sandblasters. If you need a deep, rough cut on your glass that you want to be very harsh looking in its final form, silicon carbide is a great choice. It's going to dig through the glass much faster. It's going to leave a more white, crackled surface on the glass from the sandblasting. If you're looking for appearance and you want something to be a little softer, aluminum oxide in your sandblaster is a very good choice. It's going to be less dusty because it does not break down as quickly, but it's going to leave a finer surface on that finished sandblast look on your glass and not go as deep if you're sand carving. With silicon carbide, it also lives in a lot of different tools outside of your sandblaster, the most common of which are silicon carbide grinding belts. This is a very small belt that fits onto an expanding drum. There are much larger belts that fit onto floor standing and tabletop wet belt sanders. This is the most common abrasive used in grinding belts for your belt sanders, and you now know why that is. It's a very sharp abrasive. It attacks your glass very quickly and removes material at a fast rate, although we also know it will break down faster, which is why these belts are not terribly expensive, and there's a single layer of silicon carbide on these. It does a great job for very quick removal of your glass, moving down the line to finer and finer grits, and then moving to something like an aluminum oxide type belt that will give you a much softer finish on your glass. Having talked about aluminum oxide, you now know that the aluminum oxide is a softer abrasive. So you know that these are excellent tools for pre-polishing your glass. They're going to give you a softer appearance on the glass. They're going to have a long lifespan due to the fact that it will not break down as quickly. Now with these tools, the Pulver one, there is aluminum oxide all the way through these wheels. So extremely long-lasting tool. The same thing with these 3M Trizac belts is there are microscopic little pyramids on the surface of this belt that have aluminum oxide in there. So it's a fairly good layer of aluminum oxide in there. So these are good long-lasting tools for your pre-polishing on your glass as well. You also know that they will not really cut into your glass all that quickly because they are not a very sharp abrasive. So it's a good thing to remember when you're thinking about which type of tools to use for your cold working finishing. Now, our final abrasive we're going to look at today is going to be our pumice. Now, pumice is basically just ground up volcanic rock. That's all it is. You've seen pumice stones that you can use for washing your hands or doing things like that. That's all this is. It's just a volcanic rock in a powdered form. Now, pumice is graded a little bit differently from our other abrasives like our aluminum oxide, silicon carbide, and diamond. All these abrasives are generally classified via grit or mesh size. To give you an example, this is a 140 grit diamond, a 220 grit silicon carbide, and a 220 grit aluminum oxide. Now, this pumice that I have here is not really graded as a grit. It's graded in degrees of fine. So this particular pumice here is a 2F or double fine. A zero pumice would be a rough pumice. So anything above a zero, say a 1/2 or a number 1, is a rough grade pumice. Anything below a zero becomes either a double fine or a triple fine or a quadruple fine on down the line as to how finely ground this abrasive is. Now, pumice is a 6 on the Mohs scale. It's not very abrasive against the glass, which is already either a 5 or a 5.5. They're really close kissing cousins. So pumice is used for a pre-polish finish on the glass because it's not going to give you a lot of removal of the glass surface. That makes it an excellent choice for cleaning up the glass surface from other abrasives that you may have used previously to try and get to a polish. Pumice is very friable. It will break down very quickly, but it is also terribly inexpensive. It is the most friable of all our abrasives that we have on this table. So it does break down extremely quickly. The nice thing about that is the longer you use it, the finer the surface on your glass will be. Pumice is rarely embedded as an abrasive. It's usually going to be used as a loose abrasive because it is so close to the Mohs scale of the glass. It's going to operate a little bit differently than an embedded abrasive like the silicon carbide, aluminum oxide, or diamond abrasives. Pumice is typically used with a carrier that will provide some friction between the pumice and the glass. Things like this MJ wheel from Pulper. As you may be able to see from the video, there are little threads in the wheel. This helps move the pumice around on the surface of the glass and abrade the glass a little bit. If you've got pieces that have areas that are hard to get into, say you're doing pot de verre or a cast glass piece that has different bas relief on the surface, there are also things like this brush wheel that are made by Merker in Germany. This is used also with pumice to move the pumice into those areas where the brushes will move into your glass. Now remember, pumice is a 6 on the Mohs scale, where glass is a 5 or a 5.5. So using something like this to move that pumice through a bas relief area will not damage the glass as much. It'll do very minimal removal of the glass. So it just gives you a nice clean surface to work with. So this is often how pumice is used. You can even use it with stuff like a Scotch-Brite pad from 3M to move it around on the surface of your glass by hand. They also make larger MJ wheels like this that you can use on a flat lap grinder. It is also used in large cork wheels on cork and felt polishers for giving you a pre-polish on the glass. But it is almost always used as a loose abrasive with some sort of media to carry it. Hopefully our quick overview of different types of abrasives that can be used in your cold working and how they operate on your glass is going to help you when you make your decision about which product is going to do to your glass what you need done to your glass, as they all operate a little bit differently. I think knowing how these abrasives operate is going to go a long way towards helping you understand which tools are going to work the best for your glass cold working. Thanks for joining us.